Hello friends. In this video, we will once again touch upon the topic of backup power, which is so important in a smart home. I have repeatedly talked about various devices, upgrades, and automations for the smart home to function during power outages. If you missed something, you can find the links in the description. The hero of this review seems to be an ordinary 12-volt power supply unit, but what sets it apart from its analogs is the ability to connect an external battery, which will serve as a power source in the absence of an external power grid. Once the external power is restored, the battery will recharge. Since I had several unused lead-acid batteries left after upgrading my UPS, I acquired this power supply unit to organize emergency lighting. Watch my video to see how it turned out. But before we begin, please like this video so more people interested in gadgets and smart homes can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Type of device, power supply with UPS function. Model, MZMWSC-180W. Numbers mean power, 180 watts. The model line also includes 35, 60, and 120-watt versions. Its specifications. Input voltage, 90 to 132, or 180 to 264 volts, set by a switch. Output voltage, 12 volts, there is a 24-volt version. Maximum current, 13.5 amperes. For the 24-volt version, 6.5 amperes. Battery voltage, 13.8 volts. In the 24-volt version, 27.6 volts. Charging current, up to 1.5 amperes. For the 24-volt version, 1 ampere. Battery cutoff voltage, from 9.5 to 11 volts. Size, 199 by 98 by 38 millimeters. The device comes in a box made of recycled cardboard, with a small window on one side through which you can see the specific model inside. The package includes only the power supply unit itself, sealed in plastic. There is nothing else, no manual or diagram. This isn't critical for me, but it might be important for some. I chose the most powerful version at 180 watts because it has the highest stated battery charging current, 1.5 amperes. For other models, it's no more than 0.5 amperes, and the plan load is quite small. The metal casing of the device got slightly damaged during transit, but everything inside remained intact, which is the main thing. I fixed the casing with a few hammer blows, of course, after removing it first. I plan to remove the casing anyway to show the power supply's components. This is the input voltage switch, which was initially set to 220 volts. Before first plugging it into the network, make sure to check this yourself, at least by looking through the holes in the casing. View from the other side. The power components are secured to the power supply unit's casing with a metal plate, which acts as a heat sink. Thermal paste is used for better heat transfer. In my opinion, everything is made quite well and solidly, but this will be clearer during operation. A pair of large electrolytic capacitors ensures seamless switching to and from the battery. Structurally, the hero of this review is not particularly different from ordinary power supplies in this form factor, which are used, for example, for LED lighting. There is a screw terminal block with 5 contacts, incoming phase, neutral, and ground, and outgoing plus and minus. The difference lies in this pair of wires intended for connecting the battery. I will be using a lead acid battery that I have left after upgrading my UPS, but in the future, I plan to switch to lithium iron phosphate as well. 3 LEDs indicate the operating mode. The red one in the center lights up when the power supply is connected to the network. The yellow one on the left indicates battery charging, and the green one on the right operates when there is no external power running from the battery. A potentiometer allows you to adjust the output voltage. Well, it's time to start the tests and measurements. Let me remind you that the brown wire is the phase, the blue wire is the neutral, and the yellow with a green stripe is the ground. Checking the voltage with the default settings, without load and battery. In this mode, only the red LED is lit. The result is 12.8 volts. Since I started the power supply without a battery, it doesn't attempt to charge it, and the voltage on the wires is just over 3 volts. During operation, when there is external power, the load works directly from it, without burdening the battery. This is starting with the battery, but without external power. The voltage at the output and the battery is the same. I turn on the external power. The output voltage remains almost unchanged, while the battery voltage rises to 14.2 volts. At the moment of switching, there is an audible click from the relay that switches the sources between the mains and the battery. In this mode, the power comes directly from the battery. More than 14 volts for buffer mode seemed too much to me, so I decided to adjust the voltage. The adjustment affects the load as well. At 13.8 volts on the battery, the load voltage was less than 11 volts. Accordingly, when switching from mains power to battery power, there is a voltage jump from 11 to more than 13 volts. And when switching back to mains power, there's a reverse drop to 11 volts. This might not be critical for many devices, but it's something to keep in mind. However, I didn't notice any power outages during the switching process. After all the tests, with a fully charged battery, I managed to set 11.33 volts at the load output and slightly more than 13.8 volts at the battery. To do this, you need to disconnect one of the terminals from the battery, set the desired voltage, and reconnect it. Due to the voltage difference, the light will shine brighter when switching to battery power than when powered from the mains. Cold start. The power supply is disconnected from the mains. I connect it to the battery. Nothing happens. It needs to be started once from the mains with the battery connected. And only after that can the power supply switch to it in case of a failure. Testing the power supply's capacity. It is rated at 180 watts, but the current should not exceed 13.5 amperes. The unit handled a current of 15 amperes, though the power was about 160 watts due to the lower voltage. We can consider the test passed. Now I will conduct tests with the connected battery. Its nominal capacity is 9 Ah, but in reality, it is lower since it has been used. However, for this test, the exact capacity is not necessary. I will start the test with 2.5 amperes while the power supply is connected to the mains. Now I simulate a power outage. Under this load, the voltage on the battery is just over 12 volts, and the power is over 30 watts. For a complete test, the current drawn from the battery can also be measured. Here's how it looks in real time. Increasing the current to 5 amperes, the battery voltage dropped slightly below 12 volts due to the higher load and discharge. The power is about 60 watts. At 7.5 amperes, the power is almost 88 watts. My actual load will be much lower. 9 amperes is equal to the battery's capacity value, 1C, which is not recommended to exceed. The power is over 100 watts. Shutdown. The power supply cut off the battery when the voltage dropped below 10 volts. The battery is fully discharged. I turn on the power. Unfortunately, I didn't see the promised 1.5 amperes. Actually, it was less than 0.9 amperes. I will use it for emergency lighting, together with the Zigbee controller C01Z. You can find the link to its review in the description. Along with the power supply, I also ordered an LED strip, which you see on the screen, at 12 volts, with a fixed color temperature of 4000 Kelvin, 480 LEDs per meter, totaling 3 meters. When switching to battery power, the voltage jumps, and with it the brightness of the strip, but this can be adjusted programmatically. When returning to mains power, it drops slightly, so it can be increased by linking this event to the electricity sensor. The link to its review is in the description. Besides lighting, another problem is solved here. Most LED controllers also act as routers in the Zigbee network. Given that during a power outage, all sockets, relays, and switches with zero and bulbs will go offline, this router will take over the battery-powered end devices, preventing the network from collapsing. I believe that for the stated purpose, emergency lighting backup power, the hero of this review is perfectly suited. Additionally, this power supply can work with many other devices that are not critical to voltage jumps of 1.5 to 2 volts, such as many mini PCs and routers. For more sensitive gadgets, it is better to consider purchasing one of the DC UPS units. You will find a link to the list of all my reviews of such devices in the description. The advantages of this power supply include the use of an external battery, which is easy to replace, and the ability to adjust the output voltage. The disadvantages are the lack of voltage stabilization when powered from the battery. Essentially, the load works directly from it, leading to such jumps during power outages, and the small charging current, which is lower than stated. That's all. I hope this video was useful and interesting for you. I would appreciate your likes. They help promote this video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new reviews and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. In the description, you will find links to stores where you can buy the devices shown in the review, other videos on this topic, as well as my Telegram channel, Facebook page, and a group for discussing smart home issues. Join us. It will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time, and peace to everyone.